Binginbar Farms is a family-owned and managed operation. The main part of our farm has been the family for 152 years this year. My parents are involved every day on the farm. I've got four kids. Here and my brother has two. If they wish to, you know, pursue a career in agriculture, we want to be able to provide everything that we possibly can. The farm historically has been a grain production farm. 14 years ago, we started trading lamb. Conditions here are atrocious at the moment, unfortunately. 2016, we sort of recognised that we're probably going to need a feedlot to be able to lock up animals in a dry time. The timing has been pinpoint accurate. Basically, it hasn't rained since then. It's the only thing keeping us in the black at the moment because we've had almost no production off our paddocks in that 3-year period. When we built this feedlot, we bought 50,000 EID tags. Basically, we met up with the guys at Hitachi and developed this software solution to be able to manage our EID data and the lambs more efficiently.
When we were doing a training session, Nathan produced a book that was all handwritten around his sheep and where they were going and their weights and all of this sort of stuff. And we just had an aha moment right there and then said, what is this book and why are you still writing in it? Once we figured that out, we said, this has got to be automated. So we took our Pentaho analytics toolset and the BizCubed data trust platform and were able to bring all this analytics together. It allowed us then to be able to give him complete providence of his animals from the time they came on farm to the time they were sent to the processor. The Binginbar farms have undergone a digital transformation. They've taken 150 plus years of farming experience and knowledge, combined that with all the IoT infrastructure they have placed on farm, and now have a completely digital solution to better run their operation sustainably into the future. Hitachi works on a co-collaboration process, so we're not trying to fit them into a box that here's product X, Y, and Z. What we want to know is, what is the challenge? And Nathan is really forthcoming with ideas and creativeness throughout the whole project.
Initially, it was pretty tricky, particularly with older staff members and my old man. When we were not utilising that data to its capacity, there was a point of frustration there. We're like, well, why the hell are we doing this? Over a period of about 18 months, we proved that it was extremely beneficial to utilise the data in the way that we did. Consumers really want to know where their food is from and that it's safe, it's been treated ethically and humanely. And that's really why we've pushed the technology side of it, to get our business to the point where we can supply that information to the market. All of the data is at our fingertips, basically, because it's been analysed in the background. There's no more Excel spreadsheets where we have to go through and do that manually. Checking water trough, for example, we're going to have sensors there to tell us that the water quality is good or not. We don't have to check that pump's operating correctly because we've got a sensor down there saying that it is. Revolutionised our operation, really. There's been a pretty continuous trail of stock going missing. So we've installed four security cameras around the property. As soon as it detects motion, the analytics will look at the image and say that's abnormal activity, and then send us through those alerts so that we can act upon it. There is a really bright future in agriculture. Quite often it gets marred or tainted by, you know, drought, everything's horrible. We want to be able to leave our kids with property and soil better than what we inherited, basically. We can't make it rain, unfortunately, but it will rain again. And if we can create a more sustainable environment, a more sustainable business is enormous.